Hi guys, Sharath here. So in the last video we saw how we can use Markdown in Jekyll. We created a page, we saw how a Markdown page renders into an HTML page, and we saw some of the data types that we can use. Now in this video I'm gonna tell you how we can use Liquid inside Jekyll. So Liquid is a programming kind of programming language developed by Shopify. Actually, it developed for its own customers. Shopify is a site which provides tools to host your shop online. So they developed Liquid for their customers so that they can build their own list of products, their own themes and other things. So Jekyll becomes really special when it uses Liquid. So the good thing about Liquid is we can extract content from anywhere on the site and put it on some page or some post. So that is something really good about Liquid. So there are only three things in Liquid that you need to know in the beginning. That should be enough for now. So the first thing we see in Liquid is a tag. So a tag would look like this. It is a curly brace and then percentage, so it is enclosed with that kind of bracket. Now we use this for conditional statements, like if you want a conditional logic to apply, we use this. Let's say if else statement or for loop, those kind of things. The next one would be object. So object is nothing but outputs. So here we use two curly braces, and whatever the output we want, we'll declare that inside these braces. So I'll just write output here. And finally, filters. So filters are modifiers used for the output. So let's say you get some output and you wanna do something, you want to add something to it or remove something to it or modify something out of it, we use filters. So these are the three things you should know before using Liquid. So that being said, I tell you something about site variable. Site variables are used to access or fetch data from the root of Jekyll site. So things like site.time, this fetches the current time. Site.pages, this fetches all the pages. Sometimes you are going to use site.title, site.description maybe. So we don't have these yet. We still have to create a configuration file where we define all this. But once you create a configuration file, you can use these ones. But these two, they're already there. We have pages, time can be easily fetched. So those are site variables. There are many site variables, but I'm just giving you the basic ones. Now there can be page variables. So page variables, very similar to site variables, you can fetch page.title. They are specific to pages. Whatever you have inside a page can be fetched from page variables, like page.title. Sometimes like page dot layout, sometimes page dot content, the whole thing. So things like that. There can also be post variable. So we don't have any post right now, but if we have posts, we can fetch data from certain posts or from all the posts, like post dot title, very similar to pages. Post dot excerpt. This is like the first paragraph of the whole content, or post.content, the whole content itself. These are the variables we can use. But remember, they have to be inside object. They're all objects, so they have to be inside double curly braces. If you want to see one of them in action, if you want to see, maybe I have pages, I can use page variables and site variables. So let me use a site variable, site.pages. So what it does is, it fetches all the pages, and I think it will fetch all the content of the pages as well. So let's see it. Let's go to homepage. So yeah, we have it. So this is home page is already present in home page, but this is about is from about page. This is contact page is from the contact page. This is home page is again from the home page. So, and site.pages, okay, this whole thing is from the home page. And the last thing, this is our markdown, whatever we defined in the project page. So it is getting it in an order, like about is in the beginning, contact is next, index is next, and then project. So it fetches them in an order, maybe in an alphabetical order. Now, site.pages. So sometimes you can use site.pages dot title. I hope that works. I'm not really sure. It is supposed to fetch all the titles of all the pages we have. Let's see if that does anything. Looks like it isn't doing anything. Maybe we have to fetch one of them first. Maybe let's fetch the first one, 0. So yeah, an array starts with the first one. So let's fetch the first one. Okay, so it is fetching about. If you wanna see it inside a H1, you can just cover it inside a H1 tag. Then if you refresh, we have about here. Let's say we want all the pages individually, like we will define it 2, 3. Do we have 4 pages? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we do. So first one should be about, second one should be contact, third one should be index, and the last one should be project. So let's see if that happens. So yeah, about, contact, home is the index page, and projects. So this is how you can access data from anywhere on the on the website to any of the pages. So this is an index page. I got data from all around the site to the index page. Now we can fetch site.title and site.description by creating a configuration file. So usually we can have a configuration file in the root of the Jekyll site. So remember, configuration file is a YAML file. So its extension is YAML or YAML. So here we define variables like, key pair value kind of things. I'm not sure what they call it, but I think it's key pair. So title, you can define the whole title. Our project was Hello World. We call the same description. And this is my first website. Okay, so that's not it. You can always, you can have any number of key pair values, like something which doesn't even make sense, like buzz, nothing. So you can have key pair values and you can render them anywhere on the site. So let's imagine I want to render all 3 on my index page. What I can do is I'll have this object thrice. And here type site dot on the first one I'll get the title, and the second one I'll get description, on the third one maybe I'll get buzz. Now I have to separate them. Since it is a HTML page, I have to use break maybe to separate, or I'll do one thing, I'll put them in H1 tag. That will, since H1 usually is a block, that will take care of it. I'll do this H2. And the third one should be H3. So now, let's see how it renders the page. Here, I may have to restart the whole thing to get that. So, because whenever you change something in configuration file, you have to restart. You have to, redo the Jekyll serve thing. Only then it will get the data from the config.yaml file. Now it says configuration file. Before, it did not find any. Now it is finding one. Let's refresh. So there we have it. Hello world. This is my, oh, okay. That's a typo. This is my first website. And the third one is, site.posts. Nothing. So this is how you can easily fetch data from anywhere to anywhere on a Jekyll website. So that's what makes it, so robust. Now, I hope that helped. Please like and subscribe. In the next one, I'm going to be talking about posts, how we can create posts, how we can render them somewhere, how we can get the URL to those posts, and all about posts. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.